How about it for these musicians, ladies and gentlemen? Some of the best in the world. I can't tell you how blessed I feel to have musicians on such a high level who are also just great guys. You know, it's rare that you get to go on the road and actually still like each other for more than a year. And it's almost been 2 years, and I just can't get enough of them. And so every time we play, it's just like the first gig all over again. This gentleman here to my right, y'all know him. You sure should know him, because he's been blazing the trail for a while now. When I first met him, he was a freshman at the Berklee College of Music, and I was still in high school. And he's one of those kind of guys that's so talented, it really must be frustrating to be him. You know, I'm serious. You know? You know what I'm saying? Just be running all over people all the time. Born and raised in that booming metropolis known as Eau Claire, Wisconsin. Now a native of Oakland, actually. Say hello to Mr. Jeff Keyser. The one and only Jeff Keyser. Back here on the drums. From East St. Louis. 2 years ago when I was looking for a new drummer, Diane Reeves called me up. She said, "Hey, are you looking for a new drummer? Well, I got the guy for you. I know what you need, and I think you'll like this cat." And how right she was. How about for Mr. Terrion Gully? Terrion Gully. Mr. T. And this gentleman here on the saxophones and the flute, as you're about to hear, what can I say about him? When I first met him, he was a member of Roy Hargrove's band. This was in 1992. And man, if I told everyone what you mean to me as a friend and as a musician, they'd think something funny was going on. So I'll just leave it at that. He's just one of the best on the stage and off. He's the man. Mr. Ron Blake. Ron Blake. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. A fella down here, when we walked out, said, "Welcome home." Now, that's how I feel. You guys have always been the best. Seriously, I mean that. This is one of the best atmospheres any musician could play in. You know, all the people are warm, you come to hear some good music, and you're not your usual jazz crowd. And you know what I'm talking about. You know, I don't know what happened to jazz in the last 20 years, but somewhere along the way, the audience started getting too polite. And, you know, cats be up there burning and sweating and working hard, and folks just be... I don't know what the problem is, but you guys aren't like that, so we appreciate that very much, because, you know... Thank you. I don't know if you've heard this band before, but you know, really, we're a rock and roll band disguised as a jazz group. So we need some noise. So as the night progresses, it's gonna get a little more wilder and wilder and wilder. So that's the way we like it. Next, we're gonna play. This is a song that we know you'll recognize. So we're not gonna tell you the name of it. But if you've never heard us do this song before, when you hear the melody and you recognize it, let us know by applauding, okay? It was a number one pop song in 1977. So if you listen to Top 40 Radio in 1977, you should know this tune. Hell, if you listen to Pop Radio in 1987, you should know this tune. Thank you. Thank you. We hope you recognize that as Steely Dan's Asia. You did, didn't you? We played in St. Louis a couple nights ago, and some lady was like, yeah, I know, that's that Earth, Wind, Fire tune. I said, no, darling, you're a little off. This is a song that Miss Diane Reeves and Mr. Herbie Hancock recorded with me. And this is called Lullaby for a Ladybug. Hope you enjoy it. take it on up a little bit. Play a song by, he called himself the greatest bass player who ever lived, and not too many people can argue with him, Mr. Jaco Pastorius. And this is our version of Jaco's Havana.
Thank you. Arizona.
Whew, weather report lives.